In this video, we are going to study about the clavipectoral fascia. It is a strong sheet of fascia. This fascia stretches from the pectoralis minor muscle to the clavicle. Medially, it fuses with the anterior intercostal membrane of upper two spaces. Laterally, it is attached to the coracoid process. So this is the coracoid process. So it is attached to the coracoid process and blends with the coracoclavicular ligament. Above, the fascia splits to enclose the subclavius muscle, and it is attached to the two lips of the subclavian groove of the clavicle. The posterior layer, it blends with the axillary sheath and extends upward to anchor the inferior belly of omohyoid to the clavicle. The portion of the fascia along the lower border of the subclavius extending from the coracoid process to the first costochondral junction is thickened to form the costocoracoid ligament. Below, the fascia splits to enclose the pectoralis minor muscle, and then it reunites at the lower border of the pectoralis minor muscle and extends downward as the suspensory ligament of the axillary fascia. So this is the suspensory ligament of the axilla, which blends with the summit of the axillary fascia, and this helps in maintaining the hollow of the armpit. Next, we'll see what are the structures that pierces the clavipectoral fascia. First one is the cephalic vein. Next, the thoracoacromial artery. Next, the lateral pectoral nerve. And the lymphatics from the infraclavicular nodes and from the mammary gland to the apical group of the axillary lymph node. So these four structures pierces the clavipectoral fascia. Cephalic vein, thoracoacromial artery, lateral pectoral nerve, and the lymphatics from the infraclavicular nodes and from the mammary gland to the apical group of the axillary lymph nodes. So this is a diagrammatic representation of the clavipectoral fascia. So this is a pectoralis minor muscle, and this is the subclavius muscle. The fascia which extends between here is a clavipectoral fascia. So this fascia fuses medially with the anterior intercostal membrane of the upper two spaces, and laterally it is attached to the coracoid process and it blends with the coracoclavicular ligament. Above, the fascia splits to enclose the subclavius muscle, and it is attached to the two lips of the subclavian groove of the clavicle. The posterior layer, it blends with the axillary sheath and extends upward to anchor the inferior belly of omohyoid muscle to the clavicle. The portion of the fascia along the lower border of the subclavius extending from the coracoid process up to the first costochondral junction is thickened to form the costochoracoid ligament. So this is the costochoracoid ligament. Below, the fascia splits to enclose the pectoralis minor muscle, and then it reunites at the lower border of the pectoralis minor muscle and extends downward as the suspensory ligament of the axilla, and it blends with the axillary fascia and maintains the hollow of the armpit. So these are the structures that pierces the clavipectoral fascia: the cephalic vein, the thoracoacromial artery, the lateral pectoral nerve, along with the lymphatics from the infraclavicular nodes and the mammary gland to the apical group of the axillary lymph node. This is another diagrammatic representation. So this is the view of the parasagittal section of the axilla. So here you can see the clavipectoral fascia. So this is the clavipectoral fascia. So this clavipectoral fascia, when it goes up, it divides into two layers, anterior layer and a posterior layer, enclosing the subclavius muscle, and getting attached to the lips of the subclavian groove of the clavicle. So this posterior layer, it blends with the axillary fascia and extends upward to anchor the inferior belly of the omohyoid muscle to the clavicle. The clavipectoral fascia splits to enclose the pectoralis minor muscle. At the lower border of the pectoralis minor muscle, it unites and forms the suspensory ligament of the axilla, and it fuses with the summit of the axillary fascia, and this is how it maintains the hollow of the armpit. So here you can see the structures that pierces the clavipectoral fascia: the cephalic vein, the thoracoacromial artery, the lateral pectoral nerve, and the lymphatics.